Every day, we use energy to power our homes, cars, and more. But most of that energy comes from fossil fuels. So what exactly are fossil fuels?
Well, fossil fuels are made of the preserved remains of ancient plants and algae, and they come in a variety of flavors.
To explore how the three main types of fossil fuels formed, we need to go back in time, 300 million years ago, before dinosaurs roamed the Earth, when the planet was very different and it had a more tropical and humid climate.
Over time, dead plant material that once captured energy from the sun was deposited in swamps and then turned into peat, a dark brown soil-like material. The peat was slowly buried as more and more material was deposited over it, and over millions of years it was transformed into coal by high heat and pressure.
In a similar process, but slightly different environment, oil and natural gas were formed. In this case, the remains of microscopic algae sank to the bottom of the seas and then were buried over time, transformed by heat and pressure into liquid petroleum or oil and natural gas.
All fossil fuels contain hydrocarbons. Carbon and hydrogen bonded together. When hydrocarbons are burned through a chemical reaction, they produce a lot of energy that power our cars, homes, and cities.
Most energy in the United States is produced by coal, petroleum, and natural gas for things like electricity, transportation, and heating.
But you might also be surprised to know that petroleum is also turned into a lot of our household items, such as plastic bags and bottles, footballs, clothes, cell phones and laptops, and in many cases, soap, shampoo, and toothpaste.
It seems like fossil fuels are really important to us. So what's the problem?
Well, as you've probably heard, fossil fuels aren't that environmentally friendly. For one thing, when we extract the fuel from the ground by pumping or mining it, that can destroy the land, water, and air around us.
When fossil fuels are burned, they produce carbon dioxide, or CO2, a greenhouse gas that occurs naturally in the atmosphere. This CO2 traps heat from the sun near the surface of the Earth. This greenhouse effect is necessary for keeping the Earth warm and cozy. But burning fossil fuels increases the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere to levels that make the Earth too warm. Over the last few decades, we've only increased our use of fossil fuels. Plus, any CO2 we add to the atmosphere stays there for about 100 years. So the problem and the warming is only getting worse.
And our atmosphere isn't the only thing affected by burning fossil fuels. About one quarter of CO2 emission is actually absorbed by the ocean. This ocean acidification can harm life in the sea.
And here's another problem with fossil fuels that has nothing to do with our environment, but rather to our future energy needs. Fossil fuels are non-renewable resources, which means it takes them longer to form than for us to extract them from the earth to turn into plastics, fuel, and toothpaste.
There's a bright spot in the middle of all this fossil fuel dependency. Many people are incorporating more sustainable energy into powering their homes and cars. Or more importantly, they're changing their habits to be more energy efficient. What types of solutions can you think of to reduce fossil fuel use? Become empowered to power the world cleanly and sustainably.